In this video, I'm going to introduce you to layout managers. Swing provides several layout managers that determine the positioning of your components. There's a method called setLayout. It is inherited from class container. The argument path to setLayout must be a layout manager, which means a class that implements the interface layout manager. Layout managers do basically two things. They calculate the size, minimum, preferred, maximum size of a container, and they lay out the container's children. Most of the time when you choose a layout manager, it is either for a J-handle or a content pane. J-handles have the flow layout as their default layout. Content panes have border layout as their default layout. Here, I created a new J frame in WindowBuilder to demonstrate layouts. I want to point out that the content pane, which is a field of type J panel, has the layout set to border layout. So by default, the J panel would have a flow layout. WindowBuilder sets it to a border layout, so we start by demonstrating the border layout. I go to my design view, and I'm going to place buttons in the different areas. I use buttons because they are easy to see. I place one west. This is my button one. It goes from top to bottom on the west side and the left side. I use a second button, which I'm going to place in the north area right here. I call it button 2. Notice it displaces my button 1. My button 1 no longer touches the top. Button 2 goes from the very left to the very right. I grab a next button and I place it in my east corner, and I call this my button east 3. And I'm going to add yet another button right here, south. This is a very long button name 4, and I'm going to add one other button right here in the center. I just call it B5. Notice that the width of the button adapts with the name. Longer name, wider button. Border layout is the general layout for J-frame. It can be useful for the general layout of a window. I might have, for example, a title, maybe a footer, and then I could have a 3-column layout, or I could take one column out, for example, and I might have a 2-column layout with a column on the right and then the remaining area for some content, maybe the other way around, a column on the left and the remaining area on the right, maybe no footer at all. You get the idea. So I can have my general layout. I'm going to run it again in order to observe the resize behavior. So I'm going to stretch my window. It's getting wider. Notice the left column width doesn't change. It depends on the content, in my case button 1, and button 1 didn't change. So left column stays the same. Center area adapts to the new width of the window, which is great if I have, for example, the content of my GUI right here in the center area. Also, if I change the height of my window, the title area or the top north area doesn't change the height, but it is really the center area that gets the most benefit of the new size of the window. And yes, my west area still stretches all the way to the bottom. Up until now, we placed a single component in the different areas of the border layout, but we could also choose a container, for example, a J-panel, and then I can place multiple items in my J-panel. So I'm going to change this button 5, the name is BTNB, to a J-panel. And I'm going to do that by a right click which gives me different options, and I'm choosing morph. I would like to morph this button to something other. What I would like is to have a J panel. And I say okay. And at this point, the center area is no longer filled by button. My center area is filled by a J panel. The name is still BTNB. So if I go back to my source code, I can convince myself that BTNB is no longer a J button, it's now a J panel. Needless to say, button B is a bad name for a J panel. I just call it main panel. And remember, window builder is bidirectional, so if I make a change here, this is going to be reflected in my design view. So if I switch back to my design view, you can see now this area is called main panel. I can make the change on either side. The main panel is a J panel. J panels have by default flow layout. So let's just place some components in this J panel and see what happens. Once again, I'm going to use J buttons just because they're really easy to see. I'm going to use a button right here and I call it content one. And it's right here. I'm going to use a new button. I'm placing it right next to it. This is my content 2. And I'm going to add a couple more buttons. A content with a long name 3. And I'm going to add a few more buttons just for better demos here. So here I see I have a content 4, and I'm going to add another button, which is content 5, and I'm going to add another button, which is content 6, and you get the idea. I can also add a button on a different location, doesn't always have to be the end. I could add one right between 1 and 2, and I call this between 1 and 2. So I have multiple options here. I'm going to run the GUI. And we are going to resize the window and notice how the content in my area flows. It's called a flow layout because it flows to the next line if there's not enough space. So if I reduce the size, just pops down to the next line. You can see how my content is placed depending on the current size. And now here I have this very long button. I can't really reduce that anymore. So at this point, it's just going to cut off the sides from the display. That's how a flow layout works.